Hi, my name is Matt, and I will be guiding you through the official documentation video series of the Raymatcher renderer in the Unity engine. The documentation video series aims to introduce the Raymatcher to you more closely, and I will try to explain everything to the best. So let's get started. Raymatcher is a universal cross-platform renderer that features a complete framework for manipulating signed distance functions and volumetric data. The renderer includes a fully customizable material pipeline and comes with an out-of-the-box toolkit library encompassing a simple voxel system, particle tracking, and a series of mesh-to-volume data converters. In this video, I will guide you through the essential setup of the renderer in a Unity project using three different renderer pipelines. Let's set up the Raymatcher for the legacy built-in renderer pipeline in Unity. The setup of the Raymatcher is pretty straightforward. First, we need a proper camera filter. Since we are using the built-in renderer pipeline, we don't need to extract any package dependencies as they are already included. We can proceed to the Raymatcher Setup Wizard window by going to the window, Raymatcher, and clicking on the Setup Wizard. I will explain all the fields of the Setup Wizard later. Fill in the parameters for the required fields, select the built-in target pipeline, and click the Setup button. Now your scene is ready for the Raymatcher. Let's set up the Raymatcher for the universal render pipeline in Unity. First, we need a proper camera filter for the URP. If you already have a correct URP camera filter, you can skip this part. Simply navigate to the camera filter dependencies folder and unpack the URP camera filter. Once the URP camera filter is imported, go to the URP asset and add a renderer feature with the Raymatcher camera filter. You can customize the settings on the renderer feature to enable or disable certain features. Once the camera filter renderer feature is set up, you can open the Raymatcher Setup Wizard window. I will describe all the fields of the Setup Wizard later. Fill in the parameters for the required fields, select the URP target pipeline, and click the Setup button. Now, your scene is ready for the Raymatcher. Let's set up the Raymatcher for the high definition render pipeline in Unity. First, we need a proper camera filter for the HDRP. If you already have a correct HDRP camera filter, you can skip this part. Just go to the camera filter dependencies folder and unpack the HDRP camera filter. Then you can open the Raymatcher Setup Wizard window. I will describe all the fields for the Setup Wizard later. Fill in the parameters for the required fields, select the target pipeline as HDRP, and click the Setup button. There is an additional step required to display the Raymatcher content in your HDRP scene. Raymatcher in HDRP runs through the Custom Pass feature. In your scene, where your Raymatcher renderer is located, create a custom pass game object, add a Raymatcher HDRP renderer feature, and assign the current session material to the added renderer feature. Every Raymatcher session has its own unique material instance that holds all its visual data. And now you should be ready. The Setup Wizard contains a few fields that define the actual Raymatcher session. The rematcher session represents an existing rematcher render identity that holds all the necessary data references, generated shaders, and dependencies. Each rematcher session is unique. First, we need to enter a unique name for this rematcher session. Secondly, we need to assign an initial camera, which is not that relevant, as this clearly depends on the render pipeline, and each render pipeline handles the camera in a different way. Next, we need to select a proper target pipeline. I'm currently working with URP, so I'm going to select the Universal Render Pipeline. After that, we need to select a target platform. Rematcher supports all platforms, each with its own limitations and restricted features. Please take a look at the official general documentation for what the limitations are. I'm going to work with a PC platform for now. Following that, we need to select a target render type. Currently, Rematcher supports three different render types. Each render type comes with its own set of advantages and disadvantages in terms of memory allocation and performance, as well as different limitations and possibilities for using Rematcher components. Choosing a render type is crucial for what you are going to do with the Rematcher and how much memory you will use. For instance, if I'm going to target a large-scale project that will contain a lot of Rematcher SDF objects, I would go with the performant render type, as it has the lowest allocation and still supports global materials at least. This render type is also recommended for WebGL or mobile platforms. On the other hand, if I'm aiming to work with voxels or objects that will need a per-instance materials, I would go with the standard render type, as it allows me to have per-instance materials as medium allocation and supports all platforms. There is also a quality render type, which offers the highest rendering precision and is recommended for high-end devices, as it uses the latest GPU features at its best. All the render types are still in the development, and their features might change in future updates. Alright, that was everything about the Rematcher setup. In the upcoming video, I will talk about the essentials of the Rematcher renderer pipeline, what the render master component is, and how to actually work with the Rematcher. Thanks for watching, and good luck!